occurrence of carbon. Carbon is found in the atmosphere, inside the earth's crust and in all living organisms. Carbon is also present in fuels like wood, charcoal, coal, coke, petroleum, natural gas, biogas, marsh gas, etc. Carbon is present in compounds like carbonates, hydrogen carbonates, etc. Carbon is also found in the free state as diamond. Here you can see the diamond, graphite, fullerene. So fullerene, what is a fullerene? A fullerene is an allotropy of carbon, another form of carbon, whose molecule consists of carbon atoms connected by single bond, and somewhere you have double bond, so as to form a closed or partially closed mesh. It is like a mesh. So the fullerene is an allotropy of carbon whose molecule consists of carbon atoms connected by single and double bond, so as to form a closed or partially closed mesh. This is a fullerene. Otherwise, it is found in all the atmosphere, inside Earth's crust, in all living organisms and fuels like wood, coal, charcoal, coke, etc., petroleum, natural gas, etc. Bonding in carbon. Covalent bonding. Class 9, you have learned about ionic bonding, that is transfer of electrons. Either you give electrons or take electrons. Here it is not possible. Why? Because the atomic number is 6 and the electronic configuration of carbon is 2-4. First shell, K shell, will have 2 electrons. Second shell, 4 electrons. It has 4 valence electrons. Valence means the last electrons. It can attain stability either by gaining 4 electrons or losing 4 electrons, or by sharing 4 electrons with other atoms. So these are the 3 options that you have. But it does not gain 4 electrons. What is the reason? It is difficult for 6 protons to hold 10 electrons. So if the atomic number is 6, number of electrons is 6, number of protons is 6. All these 3 numbers are always same. And you will find protons in the nucleus. So in the nucleus you have 6 protons, which will have to hold 10 electrons if you gain 4 electrons. So which is very difficult for 6 protons to hold these 10 electrons. So it cannot gain electrons. Next is, it does not lose electrons. Let's see what is the reason. Because it needs a large amount of energy to lose 4 electrons. See, in the valence shell you have 4 electrons. You have to remove these 4 electrons. The atom will need lots of energy to remove that 4 electrons. So what it does is, it does not neither will it gain nor will it lose. So it shares 4 electrons with other atoms to attain stability, resulting in the formation of covalent bonds, that is sharing of electrons. Since carbon atoms needs 4 electrons to attain its valency is 4. The number of electrons in the last shell is called valency. So it is 4. And hence it is called tetravalent 4. Carbon has 1, 2, 3, 4. And how do they bond? Single bonding. It shares with the other atoms in the single bonding. Next. Now, formation of covalent bonds. Covalent bond is a chemical bond formed by sharing of electrons between atoms, which you have learned just now. That in the previous picture, we have seen the picture of carbon with single bonding, sharing with one electron. The sharing of one pair of electrons results in the formation of single covalent bond. Sharing of two pairs of electrons, if it shares two pairs of electrons, the picture that we have seen was with sharing with one electron. So that is why it is called single covalent bond. Sharing with two pairs of electrons results in the formation of double covalent bond, and sharing of three pairs of electrons results in the formation of triple covalent bond. Now let's see the example of a single covalent bond, that is a hydrogen molecule, formation of single bond in hydrogen molecule. The atomic number is hydrogen. Of hydrogen is 1. The electronic configuration is 1. Valence electron is 1. So it needs 1 electron more to attain stability. It has got only one shell. As I told you before, the first shell will have the maximum capacity of 2 electrons. Since it has 1 electron, it will need 1 more electron to attain stability. So the 2 hydrogen atoms share 1 pair of electrons, resulting in the formation of single covalent bond. We have seen the picture there before. Single covalent bond. So here we are learning about single covalent bond first. That is for carbon, this is for hydrogen molecule. So hydrogen, 1 electron, another hydrogen with 1 electron, they share. So the first hydrogen will have now 2 electrons, so it is complete, stable. Another one, 2 electrons. So they are sharing electrons, forming a molecule. And the bonding here is, since it has been shared by 1 electron, that is single covalent bond, and you got the hydrogen. Next one, formation of double covalent bond in oxygen molecule. Let's see how it shares. The atomic number of oxygen is 8. The electronic configuration is 2, 6. It has got 6 valence electrons. See, the last shell has got 6 electrons, that is called valence electron. So it will need 2 electrons to attain stability. So 2 oxygen atoms share 2 pairs of electrons, resulting in the formation of a double covalent bond in oxygen molecule. See, oxygen, 6 electrons here, 2, 4, 6, another 2, 4, 6. When they combine, they share these 2 electrons. So 2, 4, 6, 8. So this oxygen will have 8 electrons. Another oxygen will have, atom will have, it has now become stable, 2, 4, and then 2 from here, 2 here. Total you are having 8 electrons. So it is now stable. It is an oxygen molecule. They have shared by sharing 2 electrons. So if you are sharing by 2 electrons, that is the bonding is double bonding. Oxygen shares with another oxygen atom by double covalent bond, and hence you have got oxygen molecule. This is an example for a double covalent bond. Next one is the formation of a triple covalent bond in nitrogen molecule. Let's see how it is formed. N2. The atomic number of nitrogen is 7. That means electronic configuration 2, first shell, second 5, valence electrons is 5, and it needs 3 more electrons to attain stability. 5 means it needs 3 more to attain stability. So 2 nitrogen atoms share 3 pairs of electrons, resulting in the formation of triple covalent bond in nitrogen molecule. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So these 3 and these 3, they are going to share. So the 3 electrons here and 3 electrons they shared, that is a triple covalent bond. 3 electrons have been shared. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 from this. 7, 8. Same way here also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So they have shared with 3 electrons. So that is why it is called a triple covalent bond. See how it is represented? 3 lines. Here oxygen, double covalent bond, 2 lines. So that is your nitrogen molecule. Covalent bond, so we have just whatever we have learned before, I have just written again. Atomic number of carbon is 6, its electronic configuration is 2, 4. Carbon cannot form ionic bond, we have already explained. It requires 4 electrons to achieve inert gas electronic configuration. What is inert gas electronic configuration? The inert gases are the ones that are in the group 8. All the shells are full, so they are lazy. Inert means lazy. See, since all the element, all the shells are complete in this group 8, in group 8 of the periodic table, they are generally stable. They are very inactive. They don't react with other elements. So in order to achieve this octet stable electronic configuration, carbon requires 4 electrons. It could gain 4 electrons, forming C4 cation. As it would be difficult for the nucleus with 6 protons to hold on 10 electrons, we have discussed before. It could lose 4 electrons, forming C4 cations, as it requires a large amount to remove 4 electrons. Thus, carbon overcomes this problem by sharing these valence electrons with other carbon atoms or with atoms of other elements. The bond formed by mutual sharing of electronic pairs between two atoms in a molecule is called covalent bond. So, whatever we have discussed before in other slides, I have put them all together. Let's see the picture here. The first one, single bonding, 4 electrons, 1, 2, 3, 4 being shared. Double bond, 2 here, shared 2 pairs of electrons like in oxygen, 3, 4. Triple bond as in nitrogen molecule, 1, 2, 3 electrons and then 1 here. So total should be 4, 1, 2, 3 triple bonding and 1 single bonding, double bonding and then 2 single bonding. So this is how carbon generally combine. Now we have the single covalent bond. That is, when a single pair of electrons are shared between two atoms in a molecule, example hydrogen, we have discussed before. Then chlorine molecule, how it is formed, atomic number of chlorine atom is 17. The electronic configuration is 2, 8, 7, that is number of valence electrons is 7. So this chlorine 2, 4, 6 and 7. Here 2, 4, 6 and 7, they share electrons, they share one electron each and form a single covalent bond, and this is chlorine molecule. Now when two pairs of electrons are shared between two atoms in a molecule, that is oxygen molecule, atomic number of oxygen is 8, number of valence electrons is 6. So 2, 4, 6, 2, 4, 6, and now when they combine, they share electrons. So this is one, this is the other one, they share like this. We have discussed before, I showed you before. So oxygen atom combines with another oxygen, forming a oxygen molecule by double covalent bond. See, two lines. Next is carbon dioxide. You know oxygen has 6 electrons in the valence shell, 2, 4, 6. Here oxygen 2, 4, 6, but carbon has 4 electrons, 2 here, 2 here. So the 2 electrons here and 2 electrons of oxygen, 2 electrons of carbon, 2 electrons of oxygen, they share each other. 2 electrons of oxygen and 2 electrons of carbon, they share each other, forming a double bonding. Carbon double bond with one oxygen, carbon double bond with other oxygen, forming carbon dioxide. Next is triple covalent bond. When 3 pairs of electrons are shared between 2 atoms in a molecule, that is example N2, nitrogen molecule. Then see, nitrogen, we have discussed before, what is the electronic configuration, what is the atomic number, 7. So electronic configuration, first shell will have 2 electrons, second shell will have 5 electrons, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here also 2, 3, 4, 5. The 3 electrons are shared each. See, these 3, this 3. So this is one unit will have 8 electrons. Here another nitrogen will have 8 electrons. They share, 3 pairs of electrons are shared, forming a triple bond. See the number of valence electrons, 3, 5. Next is the formation of methane molecule, CH4. Atomic number of carbon 2, 4, valence electrons 4, atomic number of hydrogen 1, number of valence electrons 1. So carbon has 1 electron here, 1 electron here, 1 electron here, 1 electron here. So they share, this carbon atom will share 1 electron with this hydrogen, another electron with this hydrogen, another electron with this hydrogen, this end hydrogen. So total carbon is having now how much? 2, 4, 6, 8 complete. Hydrogen 2, oxygen 2, hydrogen here 2, hydrogen here 2. So this is single covalent bond. Carbon sharing 4 electrons with 4 hydrogen atoms forming methane CH4. Then hydrogen sulfide, another one. Here also hydrogen has 1 electron. This hydrogen has 1 electron. Atomic number of sulfur is 16, 2, 8, 6. The valence electron is 6. So it needs 2 electrons. 2, 4, 5, 6. And 1 electron from hydrogen. They are sharing. So now sulfur has 2, 4, 6 and 8. Here hydrogen has 1. So it is shared by 1 electron. So it is a single covalent bond. Hydrogen sulfide. Sulfur sharing 1 electron with this hydrogen. Sharing 1 electron with this hydrogen. Next we will learn about the physical properties of organic compounds. Most of the organic compounds have low boiling and melting point due to the weak force of attraction, that is the intermolecular force of attraction between these molecules are very weak. So they have very low boiling point and melting point. The other one, most carbon compounds are poor conductors of electricity due to the absence of free electrons and free ions. So they are also poor conductors of electrons. Now the electron dot structure. Electron dot structure provides a picture of bonding in molecules in terms of shared pair of electrons and octet rule. We have discussed before for methane, hydrogen sulfide, etc. Even for chlorine molecule, nitrogen molecule. So this is the dot structure of ethane. Now the first member of the hydrocarbon is alkane family, methane, where N means number of carbon atoms is 1. Next one, E, ethane, represents 2 carbon atoms. ANE, single bonding, alkane family. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, C2H6. This is how you write the structural formula. Methane, C1H4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Next one is propane, 1, 2, 3. 3 carbon atoms, hydrogen 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now this is your electron dot structure of ethane. See, carbon sharing 1 electron with this hydrogen, this electron with this hydrogen and this with the carbon. So there are 4 electrons. So after sharing it is getting 2, 4, 6, 8. Here carbon 2, 4, 6, 8. Here also sharing, here also sharing, and here also sharing of electrons takes place. Next one, electron dot structure of propane. Propane means 3 electrons, 1, 2, 3. So this carbon is sharing 1 electron with this hydrogen, this hydrogen, this hydrogen. Here carbon is, this middle carbon is sharing 1 electron with this carbon, another carbon here with this hydrogen. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Here this carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4. So a carbon has 4 valence electrons. This is how, this is the electron dot structure of propane. See, same thing it is given here, single bonding. Carbon sharing 1 electron with another carbon atom again with hydrogen. With hydrogen, single bonding, single bonding, single bonding, single bonding. Here, this is propane. The structural formula, how many carbons are there? 1, 2, 3, C3. How many hydrogen? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is hydrogen atom. How hydrogen molecule is formed, we have discussed before. Then you have the fluorine atoms. Fluorine atomic number 9. First shell is 2. Second shell 2, 4, 6, 7. So altogether 9 electrons. Here 7 and the first shell 2. how will they form? They share one electron each and form fluorine molecule. Carbon dioxide we have discussed before. Two oxygen atoms and one carbon atom, they do double bonding and form carbon dioxide molecule. Carbon and carbon tetrafluoride, so single bonding. So carbon here, one electron with one fluorine, another one electron with another fluorine, another electron with another fluorine. So four electrons are being, valence electrons of carbon are shared with one electron each of the fluorine atom, forming carbon tetrafluoride. Then electron dot structure, we have discussed this before. Methane, it is much more clear. So how many carbon atoms are there in ethane molecule? One carbon here, one carbon here, therefore C2C, single bonding. All alkane families, ANE, first one with one carbon, methane, second one, two carbon, E, C2, H6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Next one. Now, types of hydrocarbons. One is saturated hydrocarbon, another one is unsaturated hydrocarbon. You have single bonding only in saturated hydrocarbon. Unsaturated hydrocarbon, you will find double bonding and triple bonding also. First, now the definition, a hydrocarbon is an organic compound that contains only the elements hydrogen and carbon. In a saturated hydrocarbon, all the bonds are single bonds. Did you see the lines? All single. Alkane is another name for a saturated hydrocarbon. We have discussed about alkane family, methane, ethane, propane I have discussed. So the spelling will be ANE, which means it is a saturated hydrocarbon. What is the feature of a saturated hydrocarbon? It is the bonds are all single bonds. Unsaturated hydrocarbons, a hydrocarbon that contains one or more double or triple bond is an unsaturated hydrocarbon. So there are three types of unsaturated hydrocarbons: alkenes, alkynes, and aromatic hydrocarbons, which you don't have, which is not in your syllabus. Only thing is you have to know the basic knowledge of alkenes. See the spelling, before it was alkane, ENES, that is double bonding. Double bonds are here. Alkynes, YNES, you have triple bond there in this. And aromatic, you don't have to learn. Now, next one is allotropies of carbon. What is allotropy? The phenomena in which the element exists in two or more physical states with same similar chemical properties are called allotropy. So, the elements will exist in different forms. See, this is diamond, this is graphite. So they have different physical states, but the chemical properties are the same. So this is called allotropy. These are all different forms of carbon. First one, diamond. In this carbon, an atom is bonded to four other atoms, forming three-dimensional structures. This is the structure of the diamond, which is not there in your syllabus. I've just given you a basic information. What you should know, it is the allotropy of carbon. You should know diamond is one of the allotropy of carbon. One allotropy of carbon is diamond. It is the hardest substance and an insulator, and it is used for drilling rocks and cutting. It is also used for making jewelry. These are the uses of diamond. Next is graphite. In this, each carbon atom is bonded to three other carbon atoms. So it is a good conductor of electricity and it is used as a lubricant. So these are the uses of, these are the uses of diamond, and this is the use of graphite. Here it is bonded to four other carbon atoms. Graphite, three other carbon atoms. This is a good conductor of electricity and it is used as a lubricant. Okay, thank you. The next part, I have split the video into two parts so that it will be easy for you to download. This is the first part. Second part, you will have the remaining portion, and I have written the assignment questions as well as the portfolio work, but I am giving you in PDF also those work that you have to do for assignment as well as portfolio. That will be a different thing. If you want to see from the video, you can see as well. Thank you.